This is a story about a girl named Lucky. Early morning, she wakes up. Knock, knock, knock on the door. It's time for makeup, perfect smile.
Sports fans, had to come to you with my reaction to the New Orleans Saints defeating the Carolina Panthers 34-31 in a thriller of a game. But the reason I picked Lucky by Britney Spears for the intro is because the Saints were just that lucky in this matchup. We were lucky to win. We should have blown them out, in my opinion, honestly. You think about all the penalties the Saints had in this one. Just crazy amount of penalties and a crazy amount of yards on those penalties that kept Carolina in this game. We get up by 14 to start the game. PJ Williams, he's a solid corner, right? But he's not someone who you should have on the outside. He's someone who you have on the inside, sticking shorter routes because he gets burnt a lot on deeper routes. And the reason is because he's undisciplined. On Carolina's first touchdown, he's playing man-to-man. Knows this. Looks like he knew this going in. But for some reason, he's looking in at the quarterback instead of looking at his wide receiver like you do in man. In man, you look at your wide receiver until the ball goes up. You see the wide receiver looking up for the ball. Unless you're already in position to look at the ball, that's when you look for the ball. He's looking at the cornerback, or the quarterback, excuse me. Wide receiver runs right past him. Carolina gets hope. The door is open. They climb back into the game. Saints, you're expecting them to go in, halftime, make adjustments. First possession of the second half, they score a touchdown, start to create separation. That's what they do. They do that in this matchup. They create separation, and then Carolina finds their way back into the game once again. So you have to give Carolina credit for staying in this game. You also have to acknowledge the Saints got lucky because Carolina's kicker was swallowing chicken bones out there. choking as he missed two extra points and the potential game-winning field goal, right? Now, for the Saints, Drew Brees had a pretty good game. He missed a throw here or there, like the throw to Ted Ginn that could have been a game-winning touchdown. We wouldn't have to settle for a field goal. That should have been an easy deep throw for him. Ted Ginn was wide open, had the whole side of the field to go to because he was burning Eric Reed, and you throw it to the other side where Eric Reed is actually closer to. You know, I don't know what happened on that one, but Drew has struggled on deep balls the last couple of years now. But with that said, still a very good game from Drew. People who complain about Drew Brees, we could be in a very worse situation. Like, you look at Chicago, look at some of the other teams that need quarterbacks right now, and we still have Drew Brees and Teddy Bridgewater on the bench. Like, we're very lucky in that aspect. But I think sometimes our coach and Sean Payton can depend too heavily on Sean Payton, right? Because we have two very good to great running backs in Alvin Kamara and Latavius Murray. Alvin Kamara was averaging 4.9 yards per carry in this game, doing his thing. And Latavius Murray was averaging over 6 yards a carry in this game. And you still combine for less than 20 carries between them, that's inexcusable. There should be a minimal of 25 carries between those two guys in a game. Now, I understand the new analytics and all that stuff say that passing is way better than running. Now, I get it. You're going to pass more than you run the ball. But it's still important to have a run game for clock management, to have a balance, to even though they say it's not important to set up play action, it still has some impact. If your running game is just garbage, your play action is not going to be that effective. But if you have a good running game like the Saints do have when they use it, play action works. One of the touchdowns that the Saints got that was very easy to Tre'Quan Smith was because of play action. Both cornerback and safety bit down on that play action. Tre'Quan Smith over the top, easy peasy pass for Drew Brees. Created off the play action because the run game was working. So you have to have that run game for Drew Brees to be as effective as he can be. What more can I say about Michael Thomas? Can't guard Mike. Can't guard him. He's too strong. Best receiver in the NFL. Had an excellent game today. His season's been more than excellent, more than phenomenal. I can't even explain or you think of a word. Superb. Just whatever. Upper echelonian. Whatever word you want to think of to describe what Michael Thomas is doing this year. Whatever describes superior is what Michael Thomas is doing this year. I hope he can break Marvin Harrison's record for receptions in a year. But you got to give props to Carolina for staying in like they did. Kyle Allen had a pretty good game. He's been up and down this year. It's going to be interesting to see what they do going forward with him. Going into next year, do they keep Cam? Because Kyle Allen's proven himself to be an NFL quarterback. But is he a starting quarterback is the question, right? Christian McCaffrey is an absolute monster. The fact that he can carry the load that he carries, catching and running the ball, makes me even more upset that the Saints won't do it with two good running backs. But I digress. We got a short week. We got Atlanta coming up. Let's get ready to get this fried Falcon on Thanksgiving. All right? Make sure you follow me on all social media platforms at The Real Deal WDA. And until next time, go real or go home.